Swift and Dell.
Rihanna cemented her new sound and attitude with the release of the chart-topping Rude Boy. Come on, Rude Boy, boy,
can you get it up? Definitely fearless and a little more grown up. It just represents my liberation, my freedom now. Tonight I'ma let you
be the captain. Her newfound confidence resonated with her audience and made Rude Boy the most successful single on Rated R.
I wanted to make the song of a lifetime. It was definitely me expressing myself as an artist in a very true way.
A worldwide hit, Rude Boy helped define Rihanna as a performer not afraid to challenge herself or her fans.
I wanted to change the sound of radio, and I felt like we achieved that.
What's up, MTV? How you doing? I'm Usher.
Hey, I'm still here. I didn't disappear from the party. Oh my
God. With the release of OMG, R&B superstar Usher hit the number one chart position worldwide, and the song immediately became a club favorite.
Ultimate dance track. You know, this is definitely one of those songs that speaks to the entire world. It opened up a lane for a new sound, a new energy.
Taken from Usher's sixth album, Raymond vs. Raymond, OMG was written and produced by Black Eyed Pea, Will.i.am.
Well, every time that me and Will got together, we came together with something incredible. Oh My God is one of the biggest pop records I'd ever had in my career. I love it.
I hope you book an appointment to the dentist because you're going to need it after watching this.
The multi-platinum smash hit the number one spot in over 10 countries and featured fellow West Coaster Mr. Snoop Dogg.
Tone, tan, fit, and ready.
You think of, like, the things that make up the West Coast, you think of Snoop Dogg. And I thought he would have been perfect for the song because it would really legitimize the anthem.
With the runaway success of California Girls, Miss Perry has undoubtedly paved the way for a candy-coated and effervescent future.
I pride myself on being a little weirdo.
I love that record so much, and every time I hear it, I love it more.
Bad Romance was the first single taken from Lady Gaga's multi-platinum album, The Fame Monster. Written whilst on tour in Norway, the track had some unusual inspiration.
I spent a lot of time in Eastern Europe, and I became obsessed with industrial, gothic, Eastern European dance music, and then I did these beautiful, soaring pop melodies over the top. I wanted to do something really innovative, and I think I did.
Supported by an award-winning video, it wasn't long before this infectious track was hitting the top spot in 18 different countries across the world.
I definitely think pop music's coming back in full force.
A song is good or it's not. Just gonna stand
there, watch me. Love the Way You Lie is the emotionally charged second single from Eminem's album Recovery. I can't tell you
what it really is. This is what I want people to hear. These are my thoughts that I'm putting on paper, and this is what I need to say right here at this particular moment. Just gonna stand there and
And who else but Eminem would invite Rihanna to sing on a song about domestic abuse?
Because I am the type of artist that always is not afraid to address things, so why should I not address this? Now I know we said
things, did things. Angry, honest, and hopeful, Love the Way You Lie has proved its worth, topping the charts around the world.
Well, once the clarity came, it was pretty much...
In June 2010, Kanye West released the anthemic Power, the first single from his forthcoming fifth studio album. The groundbreaking video was nothing short of a living painting.
I want to take it to another level.
It's just what was in my heart. The type of ideas in me, I couldn't stop.
Since 2004, Kanye has been nominated at the MTV EMAs every single year, notching up an impressive 12 nods and 2 awards along the way.
I'm trying to deliver message and melody throughout the entire thing, and I still come from a hip-hop vibe.
Despite huge commercial success, Kanye West refuses to play it safe and continues his experimental approach to music.
Those people that innovate are the people who become legends.
My name is Lil Wayne. Everybody having a good time tonight?
I've got ice in my veins, blood in my eyes, hate in my heart.
The versatility and distinctive style of Louisiana-born rapper Lil Wayne see him nominated for his 18th MTV Award.
Thank y'all. Get the world up and I'ma drop
it on your head. This whole experience has just been interesting. I love it. A millionaire, I'm a young money
millionaire, tougher than I know what I can do it, I know I do it well. So as long as I know and don't think, I'll be like.
After nearly 2 decades in the hip-hop limelight, Weezy still remains one of the most driven rappers in the game.
I don't just rap. I don't just sing. I don't just dance. I don't just entertain. I do whatever I can.
Nobody is better than me.
You don't think I'm the king of the South? Out rap. Recognize
I'm back. Hip hop standard bearer T.I. is back after a difficult year away from the spotlight.
I don't glamorize or glorify the life that I live. I'm not proud of it, but I'm honest about it.
The King of the South hopes to publicly redeem himself with his forthcoming 6th studio album, King Uncaged.
You have to have perseverance and determination within yourself to drive yourself to the next level.
With 5 platinum albums under his belt, T.I. has established himself as one of hip-hop's elite.
I'm gonna take the values, lessons, and principles and apply it to the future. And hopefully I'll be a better man next year than I am today.
Tell you what it really is. I can only tell you what it feels like. The release of Recovery in 2010 has seen Eminem lay his demons bare. You ever love somebody so
much you can barely breathe? My songs say something, and I do that purposely.
And this time around, he's taken it back to basics.
Kind of got away from what originally got me here. What originally my fans wanted to hear from me. Once I started going, it was just fun for me again. It kind of felt like old times.
With another 4 EMA nominations this year alone, Eminem is still unfiltered, unapologetic, and uncompromising, just the way we like him. I can only tell
you what it feels like. Basically, was stacking up my ammo. Well, I can't fight. And then, wham.
Big Snoop D-O double G.
Having sold over 20 million records and presented the EMAs in 2007, Snoop is undeniably the hottest dog in hip-hop.
I try to make good music. I try to stay real with the people. My record is just music, you know, and music is a universal language of all people. There's no message. There's no point intended. It's just me having a good time, feeling whatever I was feeling when I made.
This icon and visionary remains at the apex of popular culture, a global household name, and ultimately a constant force in hip-hop.
Hip-hop makes the world go round. Without hip-hop, the world will be dull.
In partnership with Suzuki Swift and Dell.